I think one of the things, one of the premises we have about how we work has to do with innovation, that we believe in innovations, whether it's an innovation in a vaccine, a malaria vaccine, or an innovation that comes along technologically. Those innovations allow us to push forward on behalf of the poor. So a great example is polio eradication. Right. We couldn't really be talking about polio eradication if we didn't have the right vaccines, the right tools, but also the mapping that's come along has what's allowed us to get down to the village level to know if we're making progress. And so we believe in innovations, making sure those come out of the labs from all over the world, China, India, the United States, UK, get them out on behalf of the poor, but then it's up to governments to scale up. So even though we've put in billions of dollars into vaccines, there are tens of billions put in by governments to scale it up so that we can have
so you're saying you do some of the groundbreaking work in the beginning, almost.
And then we
pilot
get the
projects that give people in government who have the ability to scale up, to scale up.
Every single thing we're in requires government scale up, whether it's reducing tobacco usage, whether it's eliminating malaria, whether it's the U.S. education system. And we could spend down our resources on the U.S. education system in less than a year if we were just putting all of our resources into U.S. education.
But that's one extra value they bring. Both Bill and Melinda have the ability to bring others along with them, and both governments and individuals. So there's not only the funds of the three of us combined, but they have the stature, the eloquence, the experience to talk with maybe governments, maybe very wealthy individuals, and corral hundreds of millions, maybe billions of dollars additionally on this. So there's a multiplier effect.
You would know better about this and probably better to speak about it than they are, because their participation on the ground makes a difference.
I think it's unmatched.
In a village in India.
No, it's unmatched. I mean, Rockefeller and Carnegie and Roosevelt, they did wonderful things, and they spent a certain amount of time, but they were not working 50 and 60 hour weeks, you know, all over the globe and going to some very places I don't want to go to. it's hands on to an extraordinary degree. And that not only gets results, but it attracts other people to go along with them because they know it's for real.